Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Warmaster 101. Today I am going to be teaching people how to fish for drum on Mud River. So, first of all, we'll have a look at the equipment and we'll talk about the methods that we're going to be using today. So, first thing we'll talk about the river. Now, I normally fish in between this peg, which is Last Songs of Summer, and the Pike Challenge. You can fish here at Catfish Haven, but I do not recommend it because you really don't have any good markers. However, this peg is easier to get to from Last Songs of Summer anyway, so we'll have a look from there. But first things first, let's have a look at the equipment. Right. I'm using a Tory 23, which is a nice size rod. It can carry up to 11-pound fish. You don't really need a bigger rod out than that. An Espirit MLR 3500. I'm using mono. I'm using mono 16 with a chubby bobber and a one-aught hook with shrimps. Depth of 80 inches. Now you can use 85 to 90 inches depending on the day. I personally like using 80 inches. It means that you're going to get good fluid bites. So, the area that we're going to go for, and we're going to come down here. Oh, maybe not. Come from here, okay? So, once you get down here, normally we'd go here to fish for our cats and the bass and all the other niceties. But if you, as you start off here. So, if you just turn around, you see this trail here. You go that way, it'll lead you back to the map. If you come down this way, though, and you see how the trail forks off? Well, we're going to come down this part. I'm going to set ourselves up right here next to these reeds. Okay. Now the cast, you use F11 to bring up your rod from a fop cast over to an overhead cast. It's a cast out for distance. And you see these those cat's tails at the end there? You want to be aiming for their reflection just about there. That should set you up between 70 to 80 feet out is the sweet spot for these fish. I'm at 75. Now, once you've cast out, you want to reel in the first couple of feet, simply because you want to keep line tension between the tip of the rod and your float. And then we just wait. And hopefully, thank you. Yeah, fish on. There we go. And we'll talk about the fish once we get it in. There we go. Now there's a classic little drum. Now you can see the difference between a drum and carp is that they've got a defined mouth, not just a massive like suction cup where its mouth should be. This fish has a lot in common with the koi carp, especially with the double dorsal. Double pectoral fins, and the dorsal fin being having a cut out on it. What I mean by that is it's got a main dorsal fin and it's got a subgerent fin at the back. They're always bright white, as you can see, making them really, really quite pretty fish. There you go, fish on. There we come. Here we go. And there we go, another nice little drum. Experience-wise, they're not worth as much as the cats are, but they're still good fish nonetheless. Quite good for lower levels to hone their skills on, because when you get to Michigan, you can go after the unique drum. There are some trophy drum here, but their weight is only in excess of 5 pounds. You won't get much bigger than that, so it's still good fish for, like I was saying, the lower levels and other fish like that. But aside from that, there's not much else I can tell you about the drum. Drum themselves are they're a bit of a sly attack fish because of their white coloration. They're good at scaring off predators with bright flashes in the water. But other than that, you've got to be patient when going for them, a lot more patient than what you would be if you're going after cats, for instance, because they don't always attack straight away. You have to give them a bit of time to like get interested in the bait. And that's effectively all I can tell you. The times, literally just follow the peak times on sunny days and partially cloudies. I have had some success on cloudy days, but it seems that the trophies come out on the cloudy and partially cloudy days more than what they do on cloudy days themselves. So it's a good fish to go after if you, what is it, if you're on a sunny day and you don't want to go after bass. And what you want to do is stick float fishing. Then this is a fish that you may want to consider going after, because you can still bag up a decent amount of fish with a decent amount of experience attached to it. That's just personal opinion. So let's reel in and we'll do a brief recap before we call an end to the video. So the times, you want to go for the peak time. Now peak time is when the blue line is actually closest to the top of the map. Like for instance on a sunny day you got two peaks, so those two times there are the best times to catch drum on. And on a cloudy day, any time after say 11 a.m. all the way through, if you can get them to bite. It isn't a guarantee on a cloudy day, but it is kind of a guarantee on a sunny and partially sunny day like this. The tackle, once again, I'm using a jig winner 8x10. Basically use the best float rod you got if you can, if you want to go for them. I'm using a medium standard rod here. I'm using a one-aught hook with chubby bobber and shrimp set down to a depth of between 80 and 90 feet. Find your own medium. That's the best option you got. But that's enough out of me. I'm giving you the tips. Now, run forward and catch those fish. I'm going to leave you in the hands of another montage, so hope you enjoy it, and I guess I'll catch you guys on the waterway sometime. Leave a comment, hit the subscribe button, but until later, have fun, and I'll catch you next time.
I'm not the one who's so far away when I feel the snake bite and tear my veins. Never did I wanna be here again. And I don't remember why I came.